working on the flat fenders for the Jeep. So right now what I'm working on is I've got my angle grinder here, and I've got to cut the inner part of this fender off to fit on the new flat fender. And this will keep all the dirt and everything else from splashing up inside the engine and give us a place for mounting points for our accessories on the inside too. So, yeah.
So it looks like we might have cut it right. When I get those bolts in there, that'll get cinched up and we'll have to paint that, of course. But as far as the cut goes up here, all right. So that corner piece fit just about perfect. We got plenty of room against the tube, and then we just barely made it on the inside here. Now I have to put something to fill this gap right there, and then we just bolt the fender to there, and we're golden. Yeah. Okay, so right here, there's a nut that's back behind there, and I got it cross-threaded so it kicked this part out so it won't stay stationary while I'm turning it. So what I did is I kind of beat this edge down right here so we can hopefully get that out. And it's still spinning.
trouble here. Did not work on it some more. When I say we, I mean me.
All right, this is not good. I can't get that bolt out, so I'm gonna cut it off.
All right, now I'm gonna try and just push it through, and we'll use regular bolts to get this fender on. Alright, so what I'm going to do is hammer this through, kind of get that bolt far enough through where I can angle it out, and then I'll get some new hardware to get this back on. And I might go buy a smaller here. Alright, let me go buy some new hardware. Alright, folks, we got some goodies for the old Jeep. Degreaser. Shampoo, that's not for the Jeep. Metal prep. Empty water bottles. Or empty spray bottles, I should say. Little rust reformer, rivets, stainless hardware for the fender, deep freezer again, undercoating, little rust reformer. We got some expanding foam and some marine adhesive sealant. Alright. So the plan is we're going to take our inner fender liner here and clean her up, ground down all these edges, clean all this up. We're going to spray some undercoating on there. We're going to use that adhesive sealant on the edges where the inner fender well attaches to the flat fender, right? So then we'll get a good seal here, and then we'll spray the undercoating all on the inside so none of the stuff rusts up. Alright, so let's get started. Alright. Off. Spray. All right, let's spray this thing off. You can tell this thing's been painted a few times. Thank you. All right, that should do it.
All right, let's go get some stuff. Hey, look, there's Sally. Back in the middle of nowhere, we need to smooth out these edges real quick and put this out here in the sun so it can dry, even though it's about 40 degrees outside. Okay, let's let that dry. Looks like we're all dried up. And this is why I got the spray bottle. Let that dry up and then we'll spray our rust reformer on. Alright, while that's over there drying, we are going to work on our oops that we had. So, I got that cross threaded bolt out. So now what I'm going to do is I bought some stainless hardware. We're gonna put that bolt in there. We're gonna put a nut on it, center down, and then we'll have us a little stud come out. All right, I actually read the directions and it does not dry. You just rinse it off with water first. So now let's let it dry. All right, we finally got this sucker dry. Now let's spray some rust reformer on it. So we're going to do the rust reformer, and then we'll spray the undercoating on there. This rust reformer is basically like a primer. And as you can see from the steam coming out of my mouth, it's getting colder. It's not paint. So we'll probably have to take this in inside to dry it. Alright, so we got a little problem. It says we're supposed to wait 24 hours before we apply a top coat to the rust reformer. And I don't have that time. I gotta get this Jeep out of here tonight. So we're just gonna put it on and see how it goes. We'll spray the undercoating on after we get it on there.
this fender has been the biggest pain in the butt. Nothing seemed to really go right. It doesn't fit very well. I've got too much of a gap between the flat fender and the original fender, it seems. I'm trying to get it all back together. It is what it is. It'll look good at least. I'll have to swap these rivets out. Rivets out for some bolts. I'm not sure how long they're going to last. But I can get it up there long enough to get the sealant
to seal,
and then we'll spray the undercoating on it over it. Doesn't look too bad, does it?